Good morning. Today we will start about more details about the regular expression. We must talk about Dr. Stephen Kling, Professor Stephen Kling. So there are so many scientists' contribution is there, from Alan Turing and also Noam Chomsky, Stephen Kling, because we will encounter Steve Kling's closer in our Kling's has many contributions. Kling's closer looks very evident, very elegant, but it is really very helpful to simplify the regular expression to from epsilon with NFA to regular expression, to regular expression to epsilon NFA or DFA, because all are conversible to each other. So we'll see it. Great respect to Stephen Kling. So this is regular expression. One thing you should mind that expression have the plus sign, and whenever it is a regular set, all language, say set and language, sometimes we talk it same manner, set and language, so then it is noted this way. So expression is A or AB, or here is A comma AB with this, okay. And another expression can be A plus B, and another set notation can be A union AB. I think union is goes to plus, union means union, and plus doesn't mean concatenation, plus means or. Here AB is concatenated, okay. Same here, either A or B, you should read it like this, not A plus B, you should read either A or B with Kling's closure. It may occur, it may not occur. Then it must end with two B's. So that's the language is this is. This is the language, okay. This is the expression, regular expression, this is the language. Same here, it must start with BA, definitely BA, then either A or B, please don't speak it A plus B, it is better is either A or B, star, this is the Kling's closure, and N must end with AB. What is the language? So this is the language. So it must start with BA, so this is the language, and this is the concatenation, and this concatenation you see here, it is either A or B star, N must end with AB. Epsilon is epsilon, so okay. Next slide. So language of regular expression like this, say this is your language, and these are the possible language strings. I think you can either see here lambda or epsilon here. So some books have to mention lambda. So because it's a star, so lambda must be default there. Then over, and remember the parenthesis is the highest precedence. So star is there, then A, and these are optional. A, then A may not be there. B, C. So if you then A, then another A. So these are the possible language string, the examples. This is the sigma, regular expression for the following languages. All strings contain exactly two A's. This is typical. See, whenever you are given this kind of, and one can given this kind of sentence, and you have to got it, it may be not a unique expression, but it is one of the cleverest expressions. There may be other expression possible, but this is the uniqueness of the expression. But whenever you convert a regular expression to DFA with minimum number of states, that is unique. Okay, but whenever you want to put DNA, DFA, finite automata, then the if you want to convert it a non-deterministic finite automata, there are many combinations. With epsilon NFA, you can have many combination, the one-to-many relationship. Same to regular expression, one-to-many relationship. So here, all strings contain exactly two A. How I can do this? Put A here, put A here. That is the example, to put A here, then anything, B plus B or C star, B or C star, B or C. So this way I intelligently put A here in the expression. Now take the example, all string containing no more than three A's. Similarly, what we do is we go for not no more, but there is no say restriction is that it must be three. So maybe three A or two A or one A or no at all. So that is, that captures this lambda plus lambda or A expression. I put lambda plus A expression in three places, here, 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 and then I put b plus c star and n b plus c star, and here all these things with this expression. This is the way, because lambda plus a is a trivial, because you say more, not more than 3 a's. So how to put restriction is lambda plus 1, 2 and 3. Okay, then it can occur anything, b, c, damn anything, but no a should come here. And 2 lambda plus a may have no, only 3 a's can be a member of this regular expression. But you must see, this is good expression. Next example. Yeah, set notation. I have covered set notation. I have told this is a set notation. This is the expression. The bracket is not there. Yeah, this is in it is equivalent to plus, but always better in regular expression. It is equivalent to plus, and it is in set notation. It is union. Yeah, it is regular expression. It is a plus. Yeah. These are the rules. You have to understand, because sometimes you have to give in to minimize the regular expression. Remember, in language have a set of strings. Yeah, union, it is true. Regular language, it is always true. Concatenation, yes. And this is a powers. This is also true. This is a clean closure that I have started with this today's lecture. This clean closure, it is this so simple in idea, but and it is catch. Clean closure can be captured by a DFA, any DFA. So clean closure can, but if you, I again and again telling you, if you want to compare with say a to the power m, b to the power n, if there is no comparison, it can be done by DFA, by clean closure. But if you say m should be greater than n should be greater than m, or m equal to n, all these are comparison, then you need a tool. That tool is stack. There you compare the number of a's and number of b's. Only one stack, one you push into the stack and other you pop it as per this. Okay, so then same way you can say a to the power m, b to the power n, c to the power p, d to the power q, again a regular expression. You can find it definitely, because you ignore the this thing. So operational language, say these are the two languages. Union is obvious. Regular expression is an algebraic way to describe language. For each regular expression, we can create a DFA. That is definitely true. We can create a DFA, and but a minimalistic DFA should be only one expression. For each DFA, we can create regular expression. Yes, that we practice. That I already covered. Shy regular language is nothing. Epsilon and shy, don't confuse. These are two different things. Epsilon means anything can happen, sort of thing, from state to state. And shy means nothing, blank, say black. And this is anything can happen from state to state change in NFA. Yeah, that you know. This is the language. This is what kind of language? This is a finite language, because only A can be member. This is also A is alphabet, also languages. This is a finite length is also one. Yeah. Here I think these things are, E1 is regular expression, like this should be, these laws are there, it should be union. Concatenation, you know this thing. Clean closure is very vital. Then E star is a regular expression. L star is equal to this is. So this can be done. Parenthesis is the after star, the next highest weight. If E is a regular expression, it is the highest weight. I will come to this. Parenthesis, then and concatenation is the least. I will come to this. See here, I have told you, this is the parenthesis may be used whenever needed to influence the grouping of the operators. So I will suggest you, whenever you practice, try with parenthesis. Okay, that will not create any confusion. Parenthesis means you want it first. You may remove parenthesis by using precedence and associativity. These are sometimes associativity is not true for certain rules. I will come to this. Concatenation, it is not true. Precedence, we will see it. So upper than parenthesis, then the next highest is star, concatenation is the next, and plus is the lowest. Plus means union, union is the lowest, and it is a left associative, left associative. So, like this, if you have a regular expression like this, it means like this. I think this way you can understand better. So, you take parenthesis B, then star, then again parenthesis. Whenever you have confusion, use parenthesis, like in any our mathematical problem also. So, A and then plus and then this thing. So, this is easier to understand, I believe. Though it looks complex, sometimes it is easier. Yeah, the alphabet, these are the examples. Examples are there. Yeah, this is C, zero, either 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, like it can go on. But not go on, it is a finite language. Because no star is there. Okay, so it is a finite language. Here star is there, so this is infinite language. Please, star is there, all strings 0 including empty string. So, basically this is sigma star. Regular expression examples, I have covered regular expression starting with, these are the given, starting with 0 and ending with 1. So, put 0 here, 1 here, any damn thing, how to do this, 0 union 1 star. So, this is good example. All string of zeros and 1 with even number of zeros. So, like how to make it even number of zeros, this is the way. This is the way, and anything ones can come. But there are other ways also. You can have another different expression. You can match this. All strings 0 and 1s with at least 2 consecutive zeros. So, this is the 2 consecutive, I put it 2 0, then anything come here, anything, anything come here. So, I put 2 zeros fixed. This is a clever way. There may be other expressions, but this is why I think this is the best. All strings 0s and 1 without 2 consecutive zeros. Yeah. So, you make this like this way. Never 2 consecutive zeros are coming. Equivalence of finite automata and regular expression. So, basically regular expression is good to capture any, what I want to say, that there will be 3A, 3 1s, beginning at, there should be 3 1s, ending should be 3 0s, there must be 101 combination, there must be 110 combination. I put all clauses together. I say I want a language which obeys this. So, better for each clause, you try to make a DFA, then connect the DFA with a different start state, different final state, and through epsilon connection to show this. So these are all, the regular expression is very handy tool, regular expression very catchy tool. Then you, how to design DFA, then regular expression sometimes design epsilon NFA, then DFA is better. To this. Okay, thank you. I think you have enjoyed the lecture.